President Trump's already out of Walter Reed Hospital. He's beaten COVID in just less than a week. He's something special, let me tell you. Or, alternatively, COVID is not as bad as the media has portrayed it to be. Or, alternatively, some people do get very sick and die. But most, the vast majority, have mild symptoms and recover. Don't even know they have it. Trump's got out of the hospital, and he's doing pretty well. So let's keep our fingers crossed, say a prayer, hopefully that he's completely out of the woods and it doesn't, you know, resurface or give, have a latent effects. And let's say a prayer that the First Lady and everybody else that was infected, including now Kayleigh McEnany, press secretary, all come out of it no problems. You know, we got Chris Christie in the hospital. You know, I was never a fan of Chris Christie. I like him a hell of a lot better than Murphy. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. You don't want to see anybody have problems. He's very overweight, obviously. So we'll see. But Trump's out. And I thought he made a very uplifting, good speech. And the Daily Wire agrees. Trump releases new positive video following hospital stay. Don't live in fear. That was his message. I'm going to play it for you guys. Check it out.
I just left Walter Reed Medical Center, and it's really something very special. The doctors, the nurses, the first responders, and I learned so much about coronavirus. And one thing that's for certain, don't let it dominate you. Don't be afraid of it. You're going to beat it. We have the best medical equipment. We have the best medicines, all developed recently. And you're going to beat it. I didn't feel so good. And 2 days ago, I could have left 2 days ago. 2 days ago, I felt great, like better than I have in a long time. I said just recently, better than 20 years ago. Don't let it dominate. Don't let it take over your lives. Don't let that happen. We have the greatest country in the world. We're going back. We're going back to work. We're going to be out front. As your leader, I had to do that. I knew there's danger to it, but I had to do it. I stood out front. I led. Nobody that's a leader would not do what I did. And I know there's a risk, there's a danger, but that's okay. And now I'm better, and maybe I'm immune. I don't know. But don't let it dominate your lives. Get out there. Be careful. We have the best medicines in the world, and it all happened very shortly, and they're all getting approved, and the vaccines are coming momentarily. Thank you very much. And Walter Reed, what a group of people. Thank you very much.
So that's something that's pretty incredible that we haven't heard from anybody else, really, especially on the left. Don't let it dominate your life. Don't live in fear. Now, the people on the left, they can't delineate between living in perpetual fear and being precautious. There's a difference. Okay, there's a big difference. I've been out and about since the beginning of the pandemic, whether it's working, shopping, going to all over stores. I was out every single day in New Jersey during the height of the biggest spike. Jersey still has one of the highest death rates out there. I did wear a mask indoors. I carried sanitizer with me. I always sanitized my hands before and after I went into somewhere. And then I washed my hands when I got home. I made sure I was conscious about not touching my face. And again, I washed my hands and I washed my face too as soon as I came in. Knock on wood, I haven't gotten it. But guess what? I don't wear a mask when I'm walking in the park or when I'm speaking to somebody outdoors. I don't wear a mask when the delivery guy is dropping off Chinese food or pizza at my door real quick. I mean, things like that. Okay. Yeah. So Trump is being savaged by the left for stupid things like that. So that's how you know that these people just aren't serious. They're not serious people anymore. He doesn't want people to live in fear. He wants people to understand that there's risk in life. And unfortunately, COVID is just another added risk that we have now until we can work our way around it with a vaccine or therapeutics or whatever. There's still a much higher chance that you die in a car wreck on the way to work. Still a much higher chance that you drown every time you get into a swimming pool or the ocean, especially. Your chances of dying in a car wreck when it's raining on the way to work will be even higher. They go up, I believe, 34%. Just driving in the rain. Several times more likely to die. Just driving to work. Children, 20 times less likely to die of COVID than they are the normal flu. Young children hardly transmit the disease. But here we are, still locked down in many cases. The cases are still popping up all over the place. We do have deaths. Europe, who was supposed to be the beacon of hope, they did it right. They are having cases all over the place. Except for one country. Well, there's some that did better than others, but one country now is back to normal completely. Who is that? Sweden. The one that was the most criticized because they kind of had like the chicken pox mentality. For any of you Gen Zers out there that might be watching that don't know, back in my day and everybody else's before me, there was no chickenpox vaccine. When you're in kindergarten, the first kid that got chickenpox, the parents would say, "Okay, go play with Johnny." "Mom, why is he scratching so much, Mommy?" "No, that's okay. Don't worry about it. Just go give Johnny a hug." So you would get chickenpox too and get it out of the way. That was the Sweden model for the most part. Okay? They did that and then they tucked their elderly away, which is what we should have done. But no, we have people like Andrew Cuomo and Murphy and Gretchen Whitmer and Wolf in Pennsylvania sticking infected patients in nursing homes. Half of the deaths are from nursing home and assisted living patients. Gotta be. So there was mistakes made, sure. There was mistakes made by Trump, no doubt. But on the level the left is saying, no, not even close. I mean, how much more could the guy really have done based on the information that he had? I'm tired of this bullshit narrative that the Democrats or somebody else would have done something different. Fauci himself said, "I can't imagine an administration doing anything more." We have a federalist system. At this point, the local governments take care of their local outbreaks. The president doesn't have authority to just swoop in the states and say, "Wear masks at all times. You shut down. You do this." No, the governors have to do that. That's their job. That's why they're there. That's why they make a big-ass salary. That's why they have so much power. Okay, but we could have... Listen, this was a virus. It's a damn virus. You're gonna get it. There's a very high chance you're gonna get it at some point. And we've allowed this stupid narrative to take over that, well, if you wore a mask, you wouldn't have gotten it if you had just done everything that the brilliant scientists said, you wouldn't have gotten it. Of course, going, you know, like this, when there's a Black Lives Matter rally, because that just is a totally different This is a totally different universe. That's Earth 2. That's an alternate reality. When you're protesting for racial justice, that's a different reality. The COVID does not exist there, as we know. So I like President Trump's message there. We have to confront it head on. That doesn't mean be reckless. Wear a mask inside it. Probably helps about this much, but if everybody does wear it and wears it properly, this much help compiled on top of one another for every single person, it maybe makes a difference. And then that one person that does get it, like the Herman Cain, that was especially susceptible, maybe he doesn't die. Okay, sure. So let's wear masks. Let's social distance when we can. You get into an elevator, make sure the mask is on right. If you are sick, don't go to freaking work. Smart. Just be, common sense. And I think if we left it up to people and we didn't leave it up to government, like right now, people are just hoping the government will do it. The government will enforce things. The government will take over. If it was left up to us and it was left up to us to police our own, I think people would be more responsible than they are. Because they would know the government's not going to step in and hold my hand here. So if they saw some of their coworker coughing and hacking, they would say, listen, you got to go home. Enough of this. Go home. So that's what I think we got to do. But no, I'm going to show you guys. Democrats don't get it. They don't want to get it. They just want to pander to the people that are weak-minded for their votes just to maintain power. That is it. They have one goal, maintain power and regain power. That's it. How do I know that? New York City is now shutting down again. Again. They're shutting down a bunch of different locations, a bunch of different zip codes because they're having an uptick. And they're going to destroy the whole region. And I'll be honest, listen, I live in the damn region. I need the economy to do well. I need there to be work. That's where I work. These people are going to kill us. They're going to bury us. We already have no schools open at all. And let me tell you something. I want to puke every single time I see a freaking person that has the stupid banner in their profile picture that says, don't go back to school, not till it's safe. Okay, then we're never going back to school then, okay? Because you could freaking slip on the ice and crack your head. You got just as good of a chance of doing that than dying of COVID. Okay? Of course you want to stay home and sit on the couch and do your job while you're sitting on the damn toilet. Who doesn't want to eliminate their commute to work? Who doesn't want to do that? No more tolls, no more gas, no more sitting in traffic, no more waking up 2 hours before you have to be there. You can wake up 15 minutes before you got to do your start class. You roll right out of bed. Who wouldn't want to do that? I get it, sure. But let me tell you something. I'm not paying for that garbage. It's garbage, virtual learning. It's garbage, and it's not even the fault of teachers. I'm not saying it is. Virtual learning is just a bad system. You can get away with it with college-age kids because they're adults. They can. It's up to them to concentrate and do the work and comprehend. But when we're talking about pre-K, come on. And then the districts give teachers 3 days to implement a system anyway. Then they'll tell them what to do, what's going on anyway, because they're a bunch of clowns. They're a bunch of political hacks. So I get it. Half the time the district is so unorganized. Districts are so unorganized and stupid and political that they don't give the teachers the proper things that they need to succeed and be safe in the classroom. So listen, there's two sides to every argument, but I'm not paying for this garbage virtual learning. property taxes in New Jersey, for anybody that doesn't know, are some of the highest in the country, and it's all education budget. That's the vast majority of their property taxes. It goes to education. And we have good teachers, very good teachers in the state, because we pay a lot. But I'm not paying that same amount for this virtual learning, so we get kids going backwards. We have special needs kids going backwards, regressing in all aspects. All across the board, it's a confirmed fact, indisputable. Virtual learning is shit. I'm not paying for it. Nobody else should pay for it. But you got these sycophantic wieners that say, oh, it's okay, it's just until we're safe. Because, well, who knows how they get money to survive. They don't have to go to work, maybe. I don't know. They can work from home, too. But not everybody can do that. Not everybody can afford a home tutor for their kids. Kids got to be in school. They got to be socializing. And that should be up to the parents. If parents want to keep their kids home, by all means, nobody should be able to argue with them. They want to pull their kids in. They don't think it's safe for their kid. Nobody gets to tell them otherwise. That's up to the parent. It's not up to a damn teachers union and teachers that want to sit, that just don't want to go to work anymore. So here we are. New York, Cuomo and de Blasio have shut down Borough Park, Gravesend, Homecrest, Midwood, Bensonhurst, Mapleton. These are all neighborhoods, guys. The Flatlands and Midwood, Edgemere and Far Rockaway, Gerritsen Beach, Homecrest, Sheepshead Bay, Kew Gardens Hills, Pominick, Key Gardens. So those are all neighborhoods within Queens and Brooklyn. So I think it's fine, because I would respect that in COVID, one person said. It is what it is. I support it. I see our neighborhood. I see why the rates are up, and it's understandable. Better safe than sorry, said parent Jenny Sandusky. Uninformed Jenny Sandusky. Their Queens neighborhood is in a hot zone zip code that must shut down all schools, both public and private, as of Tuesday. It's one day earlier than the mayor proposed. How are you going to handle this then if you go to work, if you work and now schools are closed? Sanchez asked. I have no idea. I just have to make it work. Make some phone calls. I'm not sure, one parent told her. My husband works all the time, so it's only me, basically, said parent Selena Gomez. So I have an appointment tomorrow, but you know, I have to stay with them now. I cannot leave them. Teachers were seen leaving schools carrying crates and bags filled with necessities to go fully remote. Some said they expected the closure and are hoping it makes a difference in controlling the rising infection rate in the surrounding communities. See, that's the thing. It only postpones the infections. How are we not learning this lesson? Lockdowns don't work. How are we the only country that's not figuring this out? And it's only the Democrats. It's only the Democrat-run states. Why? Because they want to pander to people, because somehow the media and the weak-minded in this country have made it so that the person that does the most absurd, far-reaching, ridiculous thing in response to coronavirus is the one that's taking it most seriously. They've created this narrative that's so counterproductive to actually fighting the virus that now they have to adhere to it in order to maintain the popular opinion. So now everybody thinks, oh, they're locking down again. They're taking it serious. We got to, oh, good job. Good job, Cuomo. 80% approval rating. Murphy, 60% approval rating. How? Seriously, how? They killed so many people with their stupid policies. Oh, my God. And it's not just It's not just COVID now. Guys, take a look at this. If I hear voter fraud is not real one more time, I'm going to freaking spaz out. I'm going to spaz out on somebody. This is right in my neck of the woods. I'm giving you guys local stuff for me only. Okay? I was going to switch it up a little bit because I'm getting a lot of stuff in just my local area. Now extrapolate that to the whole country. United States Postal Service confirms ballots were dumped. Said they have now been delivered, according to the New Jersey Globe. So I found this out personally, actually, from the mayor of the town in North Arlington. It's called North Arlington, New Jersey. It's about 5-10 minutes away from where I live. Maybe a little further. He said that a few hundred ballots were found in a dumpster. Look, there it is right there. You can see them. Hundreds of ballots were found thrown away in a dumpster in North Arlington, New Jersey. So I didn't want to report on it until we had confirmation that they weren't like duplicates or who knows, you know what I mean? Or they weren't counted already and then discarded improperly, whatever the case was. Nope. They were, United States Postal Service confirms ballots were dumped, said they've been delivered. A North Jersey man posted a photo on Facebook on Friday of a large quantity of mail that includes a multitude of ballots strewn adjacent to a dumpster. Just found 200 to 300 pounds of mail dumped in a dumpster behind one of the bank's I service. It was behind the bank, that's right. Including at least 200 ballots, said Howard Dinger. This is the kind of stuff you just can't make up. And yes, it was reported to the local police and postal service. The United States Postal Service declined to offer details of the incident beyond a confirmation. That's great. These are the people that are going to be deciding the next leader of the free world. The United States Postal Service. The mail you referred to was reported, collected, and delivered, said George Flood, a spokesman for the United States Postal Service. This matter was then turned over to our offices of Inspector General. We're unable to comment further at this time. Still, it's not immediately clear how local election officials will get around chain of custody issues. Dinger said the mail including the ballots were found in North Arlington and were intended to be delivered to West Orange residents, another town about 15 minutes away from there. These are all towns with fairly large populations too. We're talking anywhere between 30 to 50,000 people. So now we have a good pattern of incidents like this. Patterson, New Jersey. A lot of them in New Jersey too. Patterson, New Jersey. North Arlington, New Jersey. What's that? There's another one. There's more. Let's look at this one. This is a Facebook post because the ballots for specific towns are being sent out, periodically. So one town goes out the 4th, the next town goes out the 6th, the next town goes out. So apparently this town, Teaneck, New Jersey, got their ballots and half of the town is in a different district. So the district that's supposed to get number 9 for District 9 ballots apparently got District 5 ballots. Just wanted to make Billy Prempa, the congressional candidate for District 9, aware that many people in my section of Teaneck near the Englewood border received wrongly printed ballots with District 5 on it for a different candidate, Gottheimer Pallotta, instead of District 9. Prempa, the proper authorities have been notified and new ballots will be sent, but it's very disconcerting. If this is already happening, what's going to happen with the rest of the nation? I'm very upset that I can't vote in person. She's not the only one. How are we allowing this to happen? People that are voting Democrat, think about what you're allowing. Think about what you're doing. you're not speaking up right now because you think this is going to help your team, your side, right? Think about the consequences. Think about the consequences. It's not going to end well. And it's too late already. Guys, thanks for sticking with me. I'll see you on the next one.